Hi guys, welcome back to another video of BPrep. In this video, we are going to solve a time and distance question which was asked in ZAT paper this year. No important formula is involved as such, but you have to visualize what is happening in the problem, and then if you are able to visualize it correctly, question is very simple. Let's jump to the question. A hare and a tortoise run between points O and P located exactly 6 km from each other on a straight line. So there are two points O and P. Let this point be O and this point be P. They start together at O, go straight to P and then return to O along the same line. They run at constant speeds of 12 km per hour and 1 km per hour respectively. So for hare and tortoise, speeds are given. So hare is running at a speed of 12 km per hour. And tortoise is running at a speed of 1 km per hour. And total distance of this OP is given as 6 km. Okay. Since the tortoise is slower than the hare settles between O and P until the tortoise goes once to P and returns to O. During the run, how many times are the hare and the tortoise separated by an exact distance of 1 km from each other? So here we need to visualize what is happening. In question it is mentioned that when tortoise and hare has started from point O at the same time, and while tortoise is making one round of OP, how many times hare will be exactly at a distance of 1 km from tortoise? So as you see, there is no formula which can be used here. We need to just see what is happening and we need to proceed. So one thing is clear, that if distance of OP is 6 km, then tortoise will take 12 hours to complete one round. Okay. And while tortoise is taking 12 rounds to complete one round, hare will be able to complete 12 rounds because it can complete one round in 1 hour. So hare will be able to complete 12 rounds. Okay. So now let's see what is happening in the first round. So in the first round, both has started from point O, and this will be their path. Okay. So initially, when hare and tortoise both has started, after some time hare will move more distance than tortoise. Okay. So tortoise will make some distance and tortoise will come here. Okay, so I'll put T here for tortoise. And in the same time, hare will reach somewhere here. Okay. So distance between them is 1 km. And then hare will continue moving towards P and then will come back. Now when hare is coming back, by the time tortoise will be somewhere here. Okay. Because speed of tortoise is very less. So when hare is coming back, at this point somewhere, again distance between these two will be 1 km. And when hare is reaching here at point O, then again distance between them will be 1 km. So if you see round 1, there are total 3 occurrences when distance between them is exactly 1 km. So this is first occurrence, this is second occurrence, and this is third occurrence. Okay. So total 3 will be the number of those cases. Now if you see round 2, what will happen in round 2? Again hare has to go till point P and come back. Okay. So when round 2 starts, hare will be at this point and tortoise will be at this point. So though distance between them will be 1 km, but we have already taken care of this case at the end of round 1. So we won't consider it at the beginning of round 2 because it will be duplicate. Okay. And now when hair has started, by the time hair is reaching here, the distance distance between them will be 1 kilometer. So that will be a valid case. And again, hair is coming at point P and then coming back towards O. Then when hair has reached somewhere at this point, by the time tortoise will reach here, and then hair will keep coming towards O. So after some point, hair will again cross tortoise, and then hair will reach at O. So in round 2, if you see, first case, the second case, and third case. So again in round 2 also, there are 3 such occurrences when distance between these two is exactly 1 kilometer. Now we need to see one more case. Let's see round 3. So what will happen in round 3? Again, hair will start from point O and come back to O via P. So similar to previous round, let tortoise be at any point. So before 1 kilometer, so 1 kilometer ahead of tortoise and 1 kilometer after the tortoise, there will be 2 valid cases. Okay, so T is here, then there will be 2 valid cases. And again, when hare is returning back, so 1 kilometer ahead of the tortoise, so 1 kilometer ahead of the tortoise and 1 kilometer after the tortoise, there will be 2 more cases. Okay, so in round 3 there are total 4 cases when distance between them is exactly 1 kilometer. Now whatever is happening is round 3, same will keep on going till a point again we reach a corner case. So why round 1 and 2 are different? Because they are the corner cases when tortoise and hare are standing at the same point. So this will go on till round 6. So why round 6? Round 6 is a special case. So if you see, in round 6, it's already 6 hours now, and tortoise has reached exactly point P by the time. So if we see round 6, in round 6, tortoise will be exactly here. Okay, half of the total round distance. Now this will be a special case. So what will happen in this case? Again, hare has started from point O, and 1 kilometer ahead of T, if hare is reaching here, then there is a valid case when distance between them is 1 kilometer. But when hare has crossed tortoise and coming back towards O, there will be just one more case. Okay, because T, by the time T will make very less movement, so there will be only 2 cases in round 6. So that's why 6 was special case when T is at the end. So there will be only 2 possibilities when distance between hare and tortoise will be exactly 1 kilometer. So now when we have figured out 1, 2, 3, so round 4 and 5 are similar to 3. And now after 6, if you see, further rounds after 6, so 7, 8, 9, and it will go on till 12. So 6, 7 will be exact replica of 6, because whatever things are happening in a forward way, now same situation will occur in a reverse way. So round 7 will be exactly a mirror of 6. So if in round 6 there are 2 possibilities, in round 7 again there will be 2 possibilities. So round 7 will be exact replica of 6, 8 will be replica of 5, 9 will be replica of 4, and so on. So 12th round will be replica of 1. Okay, so now if we add up the number of occurrences from round 1 to 6 and multiply by 2. Why 2? Because from 7 to 12 is exactly replica of this. So from 1 till round 6, how many total occurrences were there? So 3 and 3, 6, 4, 10, and for 4 and 5 also there will be 10. Let me write it down. So for round 1 and 2 is total 6. For round 3, 4 and 5, it will be 4 into 3, 12. And for round 6, there are exactly 2 occurrences. So from 1 to 6, there are total 20 occurrences. And from 7 to 12, again, there will be 20 to 2 occurrences. So 40 is the answer for this question. If you have any questions or doubts, please post in comments. And guys, please do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notification about the latest videos. Thank you for watching this video.